Amen. So for us here at Grace, I'd like to introduce to you guests and visitors and sort of have an exchange here. So we're having a baptism today, and the baptismal candidate or person is Benjamin Bryden Conway. So the dad, Kyle, would you please stand? This is Ben. Let's first of all give thanks to the Lord for Ben. And Courtney, if you'll please stand. Okay, this is the mom, Courtney. Okay? Okay, you guys can be seated. Okay? So you may wonder how this all came about. I was having lunch at Edo's, and sitting right next to me was Courtney and Ben, and we were having lunch and talking, and then I said, oh, this is your baby, yes, his name is Ben, yes, and then she asked me this question. I didn't ask her, do you baptize babies, you know, and I said, no, we don't. I said, yes, we do. Of course we do. And then she went on to explain that she'd been inquiring on behalf of husband and her about the baptism of her son, Ben. And I said, well, we're here at Grace Lutheran. They are summer visitors. They are summer cottagers at Silver Creek Golf Course. Good golf course, by the way. I love golfing Silver Creek. And then throughout that process, we talked about having their son baptized here, and she met Chris here at the church, and from that I've met Kyle. We've had conversation. Just by way of reminder, Ben is being baptized into the Christian's faith, you know, so he joins almost 2.5 billion Christians worldwide. And then as he grows in years and learns to speak and learn to understand, Lord willing, that's when he will be shaped and formed in a denominational heritage. And they live up in the Spruce Grove area. And so they've already made contact, or I've already made contact with a Roman Catholic congregation, because part of Ben's family life is within the Roman Rite, Roman Church. Okay, so welcome. And all these people here, you're all part of the clan, correct? So let's see if I got it right. The mom and dad of Courtney is Gary and Carol. So if you'd please stand. Great. Okay. You have to help me out here, so you do the rest. You have to stand up, yeah, and speak loud.
Linda and Ken.
Linda and Ken, please stand. Hello. Welcome.
Okay. And this is Kelly and John right here.
Please stand, yeah. Welcome. Hello.
And this is my Gampy George. My grandfather, yeah. And this is Bobby and Debbie, my aunt and uncle. And this is Ashley, Mitch, and Bianca.
Go ahead.
This is Brittany and Justin. That's the other auntie and uncle as well.
Okay. Oh, turn and face. Okay, turn. Okay, good. Good.
And then this is Bert. How very
Jason
Burchell. Godfather.
The Godfather.
Yeah. And then this is Amy and Ainsley, my two longest friends. They are godmothers. And this is Emerson. This is Emerson, Amy's son.
Hello, Emerson. Hi. Yeah, please stand up. So you can tell us all good stories about this couple, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So Jason and Ainsley and...
this is Amy, the godmother.
Yeah. Amy and Jason and Ainsley and Steve, who's not here, these three people are the godparents. So it's a great responsibility to be asked, and you just simply are to pray for, encourage, to welcome, to show by your life the light of God in light of Christ in you, okay? So it's great. So this is the family. And again, we want to thank you for coming to Grace Lutheran. You're coming all the way from Edmonton. Do appreciate it and look forward to getting to know you better, okay? Also, you'll see in your bulletin, if you'll turn to this white sheet here. I just want a couple things to note here now at the beginning, but also at the end, because we are creatures that learn, but sometimes we need to be reminded over and over and over. So coming up in September, our worship celebrations are going to start at 10 o'clock. So together, what time is our worship celebration starting in September? 10 o'clock. Excellent. For those of you who have multilingual capabilities, you'll see in the second page here, you know, like Donka is German and Pasiba is Russian. We want to say thank you to all those who participated in Vacation Bible School this week, as well as the CLBI team. And that's great. So would you give me give a hand to the CLBI group as they were here? They're getting ready for Resurrection Lutheran now. Just wanted to highlight those two items. Carolyn, we're soon going to start the a cappella. Chris Hamilton, I need you. Okay, so you know what you're going to be doing, right? Come into his presence singing. You did this last week with us, okay? Okay, you did this last week, so this is not difficult. Is there anything? Oh, yeah, one other item. I'd like to draw your attention to. You're over this way. Ken Ma, when we take the offering, Ken Ma is going to provide a personal testimony about his faith walk in Jesus. So looking forward to it, Ken, okay? And you'll come to the lectern and take your time, but you are going to be timed, okay? Good. So Chris, remember, come into his presence singing hallelujah. Okay, hallelujah. Do you remember that? Okay. Do you feel comfortable coming and standing with me up here? Will you do that? Okay, so there is a song. There's, you know, two songs that run together. It's called Blending, two songs. And this side here, just follow Chris. The words are there noted on the screen or in your bulletin. It's just simply come into God's presence singing hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We're going to sing it once together, and then I'm going to go like this. And that means Chris's side is going to start. You sing it three times, then praise the Lord together three times. You're going to follow me, and then when we get done, we're going to go into the hymn of faith, hallelujah, sing to Jesus, okay? Are you all ready? Let's stand. Together. Come into God's presence singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come into God's presence singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Come into God's presence singing hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come into God's presence singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord together singing hallelujah, hallelujah. Hold it, hold it, hold it. Chris. We did sing, come into his presence, and then it says, praise the Lord together, sing. Ready? Praise the Lord together, singing. Praise the Lord together, singing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the Lord together, singing. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Last time. Praise the Lord together, singing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus his, the scepter his, the throne. Alleluia, his, the triumph his, the victory alone. Hark, the songs of peace fulfill. Hallelujah, bread of heaven, here on earth. Jesus is the scepter, his, the throne. Alleluia, his, the triumph, his, the victor alone. Hark, the songs of peace.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all, and also with you. Together we read Psalm 51. Together, the Mighty One, God the Lord, speaks and summons the earth, from the rising of the sun to its setting. Out of Zion, the perfection of beauty, God shines forth. Our God comes, he does not keep silent.
Before him is the tower of fire, around him the mighty generous. He calls to the heavens above, and to the earth, and to the treasures of the people. Gather to me, my faithful ones, who have come to me in my sacrifice. Let heavens declare his righteousness, for God himself will judge. Hear,
amen. Together we sing, O Worship the King, verses 1, 3, and 6.
with you.
And also with you.
Together let us pray. O Lord, you have called us to enter your kingdom through the narrow door. Guide us by your word and spirit, and lead us now and always into the feast of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated. I'm going to have to make a technical cue here to my technician. Dave, will you come on down? You'll turn to page 268 in your worship book.
Remember, it can pick up every sound. It's on. You're welcome to come over up front closer if you wish, okay? Dearly beloved, Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of St. Matthew, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." And in the last chapter of Mark, our Lord promises that whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. And the Apostle Peter has written that baptism now saves you. The Word of God teaches that we are all conceived and born sinful and are under the power of the devil until Christ claims us as his own. We would be lost forever unless we are delivered from sin, death, and everlasting condemnation. But the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who atoned for the sin of the whole world, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. So Kyle and Courtney, do you wish to have your son, Benjamin Bryden Conway, baptized in the Christian faith? If this is your heart's desire, so answer, we do.
We do.
So just turn him this way, okay? That's it, just for a moment. Ben, receive the sign of the cross both upon your forehead and upon your heart. As one who is now redeemed by Christ, the crucified and risen Lord. Let us pray. Eternal Father, we thank you that through the holy waters of baptism, you make us born anew, born again to be your son and your daughter, and that Jesus now lives in us. Grant this through the sacrament. Grant that Benjamin Bryden today celebrates with joy the salvation that you have received and earned for him, Lord Jesus. For I ask this in your name. Amen. So Jason and Amy and Ainsley, like I said to you earlier, it is a great responsibility to be asked, and if Steve was here, I'd be saying this to him, to be asked by Kyle and Courtney to be the godparent of Benjamin. It is your responsibility before God and before the couple that you will pray for him, that you will encourage him to be that person who is all that Jesus has called him to be, and that you will remember him in important life passages in his life, such as his confirmation, maybe his first date, his first kiss. You'll be there when he gets married, you know, that you'll be there when, you know, with mom and dad, all those important life passages. If this is your desire, please so answer, I do with the help of God, the Holy Spirit. I do with the help of God, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congregation, I ask you in the presence of God, do you renounce the devil? So answer, yes, I renounce him.
Yes, I renounce him.
Do you renounce all his works? So answer, yes, I renounce them.
Yes, I renounce them.
Do you renounce all his ways? So answer, yes, I renounce them. Brothers and sisters in Christ, do you believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth? So answer, yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried? He descended into hell the third day. He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. So answer, yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe.
And do you believe in God the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting? So answer, yes, I believe.
Yes, I believe.
Okay. Dum ba dum bum dum. So who's going to hold? Oh, Gary, move over there. Move over there, guys. Who's going to hold Ben while he's baptized? Make up your mind, guys. Come on. Okay. Just take off his hat, please. Okay. Just lean him over. Benjamin Bryden, you are baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Okay, just a second here now. There we go. Okay, if you could put that hat back on. And let's see if I can hold him. Okay, got him? Let's go. Wow. Hello, Ben. Hello, Ben. May I introduce to you today our brother in Christ. His name is Benjamin Bryden. So Bryden is two names, Brian and Don. Brian is a Celtic name. It means strong one, one of valor, one of strength. And Don is a Scottish name. It just simply means the chief. My God, you got a real leader here, guys. You know? He's not going to sit down on you and just sort of sit passively in the night. Hey, buddy. And Ben is a Hebrew name, which means son of the right hand. And if you sit at the right hand, you know, it's the one who's going to take over, the leader, the one following. Kyle and Courtney, through the names that you have selected, you got a little dude here that's going to be a leader, someone who's going to, you know, set the pace. He's not going to be a sheep. So, hey, buddy. Oh, yeah. Yeah. And so, you know, he reminds you of Jesus, who is your leader in your life. Hey, buddy. Would you welcome into our midst Benjamin Bryden? Here, Kyle. You have him? Okay. So, come to the altar, just right here. No, no, just right there, right there. Chris Hamilton, would you come forward, please? Because you're part of the worship committee. Got that? Excellent. Chris, if you'll stand next to me here. And if you'll, the baptismal candle, please. Go ahead, Chris.
Live always in the light of Christ and be ever watchful for his coming, that you may meet him with joy and enter with him into the land of his kingdom, which shall have no end. In holy baptism, God the Father has made you a member of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and an heir with us of all the treasures of heaven in the one holy Christian and apostolic church. We receive you in Jesus' name as our brother in Christ, that together we might hear his word, receive his gifts, and proclaim the praises of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light.
Receive the sign of the cross. Oh, just turn him this way. Okay. Yes. Knowing that through Jesus Christ he is your Lord and Savior, and that through this anointing you have been baptized by Jesus with God the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you'll turn and face the congregation. So, Chris, if you'll come this way with me. Just turn and face the congregation. Just stay there. Just stay right there. Together we say, Amen. We welcome you in the name of the Lord. Together, Amen. We welcome you in the name of the Lord. We'll just share the peace, Chris, with them, okay? Peace of the Lord. Peace of the Lord. Jason, peace of the Lord, okay? Amen. Peace of the Lord. Peace of the Lord. Peace of the Lord. You may go back. You may go back, okay? Just wait here, okay? Sing Children of the Heavenly Father. Children of the Heavenly Father, please be seated for the readings and the sermon. The Old Testament reading is from Isaiah, chapter 66, verses 18 to 23. Thank you.
Okay, Isaiah 66, 18 through 23. For I know their works and their thoughts, and the time is coming together all nations and tongues. And they shall come and shall see my glory, and I will set a sign among them, and from them I will send survivors to the nations, to Tarshish, Paul, Lud, who draw the bow, to Talub, Javan, to the coastlands far away, that have not heard my fame or seen my glory. And they shall declare my glory among the nations, and they shall bring all the brothers from all the nations as an offering to the Lord, on horses and in chariots and in litters and on the mules and on dromedaries to my holy mountain Jerusalem, says the Lord, just as the Israelites bring their grain offering in a clean vessel to the house of the Lord, and some of them also I will take for priests and for Levites, says the Lord. For as the new heavens and the new earth that I make shall remain before me, says the Lord, so shall your offspring and your name remain. For new moon to new moon, from Sabbath to Sabbath, all flesh shall come to worship before me, declares the Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Thanks, Alan. The gospel for this Sunday is St. Luke chapter 13, beginning at verse 22. Please remain seated. He went on his way, that is, Jesus went on his way through towns and villages, teaching and journeying toward the city of Jerusalem. And then someone said to him, Lord, will those who are saved be few? And he said to them, strive to enter through the narrow door, for I tell you, will seek to enter and will not be able. When once the master of the house has arisen and then shut the door, and you begin to stand outside and to knock at the door, saying, Lord, open to us, then he will answer you, I do not know where you come from. Then you will begin to say, we ate and drank in your presence, and you taught in our streets. But he will say, I will tell you, I do not know where you come from. Depart from me, all you workers of evil. In that place there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth when you see Abraham and Isaac and Jacob and all the prophets in the kingdom of God, but you yourselves cast out. And people will come from east and west and from the north and the south and recline at table in the kingdom of God. And behold, some are last who will be first, and some who are first will be last. This is the gospel of our Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Jesus went through the towns and he went through the villages. He was teaching the people about his new world order. It's called the kingdom of God. And he was always going toward the city of Jerusalem while he was journeying. Heavenly Father, we hear about your son Jesus, who had this determination, this focus. Nothing distracted him from it. Help us, Lord, as you stand here in our midst, you know, to look you in the eye and to hear clearly from you what your message is about, so that we do not become unaware, or we do not become rebellious to your invitation to come and to follow you. Amen. So how many have been watching the Rio Olympics? Raise your hand. Be honest. God knows if you're lying. Right? You know, it's coming to the end of the Olympics, 2016. And one of the main events that closes the ceremony, when there's at least 80,000 people in the stadium, is when the marathon man, the marathon runner, enters the stadium. You know, do you know how long a marathon is? 26.3 miles. You got that? That's like traveling from Camrose almost all the way to Wetaskiwin. Or if you're coming from Edmonton, it's like going from Camrose up to at least Hay Lakes. 26.3 miles. And these runners who are in tip-top shape, they're running at a clip of about 5 to 6 minutes per mile. Can you believe that? I mean, these guys, these girls, are just moving along. And even though they are in physical ability, the greatest strength of them is not in their legs. It's not in how big they are, like tall or small or thick or thin. When you learn to run a long distance, when you learn to run a marathon, it is never how strong you are. The strength of your life is located where? Take your right hand, and I want you to go like this. Right here. A marathon runner, a person who runs the race, never loses focus of the end goal. The moment you turn your eyes to the ground, the moment you drop your head and look at your toes, the moment that you look around at the circumstances is the moment you're done the race. Whether you go 1 mile, 100 feet, whether you go 15 miles, you know, you're done. It's called hitting the wall. Hitting the wall. A marathoner reminds us that you gotta pace yourself to run the full distance. I mean, it would be awful to run, right? 25.3 miles, and then you drop. Come on, Kyle, you just got another mile to go. You don't get it, I'm dead. You know, like, you know, you got to learn to run the full distance. That's what Jesus is reminding us this morning when we hear his story in the Gospel of St. Luke. He has set his face toward Jerusalem. His end goal is the city of Jerusalem. He has a purpose and a mission. It is to die on the cross, and nobody and nothing is going to take him off course. Nothing. He's got this focus, this determination, and well on the course, well on the road to Jerusalem, well running the marathon, he takes time to tell people about why he's come. I'm here, guys, for all of you who want to listen, I'm here to explain to you that God who created you has come in the flesh to be amongst you. And he brings this new world order called the kingdom of God. And I want you to seriously and honestly and earnestly listen to me. And I want you to pay attention. And if my words touch your mind and heart, then I want you to do something. And then everyone's going to say, join the race, Jesus? You know, I'm not into this, you know. He just simply says, this is what I want you to do. And Tom, would you come on up here? We are a congregation of participation and a little bit conscription. When Jesus comes by and he talks to people, he's going this way. Got it? Most people are going that way. You got it? Okay. So when Jesus comes to those people, when Jesus comes to you this morning, he stops and says, hello, I know you, you're Tom, right? And then he'll say something like, where are you going? Where are you going? He's going this way in his life. He's living for Tom. And, you know, Jesus isn't mad at that. He's not upset. He just, oh, that's great, Tom. What does that all mean? And then Tom will explain, right? And then Jesus will simply say this, Tom, I want you to come and follow me. And I'm going this way. Guess what Tom has to do now? He has to make a choice. Got it? You stay right there, Tom. You're so quick to help me out. I love that. But he's got to make a choice. A choice in life. Do I live for me and keep going this way? Or do I pay attention to Jesus and accept his invitation to go with him that way? It's a choice that every person in this world will have to make at some point in your life. It's called a decision of drama. And Tom's heart is beating right now, pound, 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 pound. And he will be led to make a choice. So Tom, I'm Jesus in this story. Will you come and follow me? And when he says yes, then Jesus takes him by the hand, and together they walk this way. Got it? That process of being turned, okay? That process is called repentance. It just doesn't happen once in your life. Every day, Tom has to make this decision. Do I live for me or do I live for him? Every day Jesus is coming and saying to Tom, I'm going this way. Will you join me? Okay, you got that? You got setting the stage for that? Okay, thanks, Tom. Let's give a hand for Tom. Way to go, Tom. John, if you had been sitting here, it would have been you today. Why I mention this, and it's because it's the scripture, why I mention this is because Kyle and Courtney, you are the example for your son. As much as you can say mom and dad and family and friends, in the end, he's your boy. In the end, he's your responsibility. I've mentioned to you, God gave you your son, Ben, as a gift for you. And in your home and in your setting, you're going to be teaching Benjamin Bryden every day what it means to move from living for him. You know, right now he's cute, right? Right now, he's with grandma, yeah. You know, and we honestly think, well, there's nothing wrong. But, you know, when he gets to be 2 years old and he learns to say what word, everybody? No, right? How many have had kids like that? Look around, you know. Kyle will say, well, man, he learned that from Courtney. Courtney will say, no, he learned it from Kyle. You know? We are by nature self-centered. We are by nature people that just want to live for me. But today, you have said to your son, you have the greatest gift given to you. His name is Jesus, who knows you, Ben, was making you in your mom's womb, fearfully and wonderfully knitting you together. You know, it wasn't just... No offense, it wasn't just you, Kyle, doing your thing, you know. It was you, O Lord, according to Psalm 139. And it's your responsibility to teach him, as Christian parents, to come and live life for Jesus. You know, it's your responsibility. No one else's. The ball bounces and sticks with you. And how long is that race till? Well, it's the marathon, buddy. No, there are times as a father of five, I'd like to give my kids over to people. How many want to take my kids right now? Raise your hand. You know? Are there struggles in parenting? How many will raise their hand? There are struggles in parenting, right? How many have pains that you've done a great job, but you've also done a really bad job? Do you give up on your kids? No. It's a marathon race, right? Right to the end. Right to the end, you show Ben, live for Jesus, live for Jesus, live for Jesus, you know? And you'll discover that the kids teach you about living for Jesus also. Hey, Dad, Are we going to church today? I don't. I want to go golfing at Silver Creek. I think I've heard that before, you know. How many would be, you know, like, I mean, that's common, you know. I want to go to a hockey game or the Edmonton Eskimo football game. Mom, you know, what does it mean to, you know, to forgive? I don't know, you know, like, the kids teach us to live for Jesus also. That's what running the marathon is about. And today, you've put your child in this marathon race. The joy for us, for all who are baptized. And I want to draw the sermon to a close in this. The joy for us is that when you get those times when you are weak and tired, and you just don't have the strength anymore to do it, to run, the joy is that you discover that throughout your life, it's never been you running the race. It's always been Jesus carrying you through life. You know, it's always been Jesus who's taken you by the hand. And in those days and times when this old world gets me down, that's when you discover just how close the gracious Father has been and is to you. But like you, Tom, hey, you got to make a decision. It was made for you young. It's made for you every day. Ben, they made a decision for you. It's the best decision in life. The Lord bless you for that. And may we who are baptized remind ourselves that, you know, parents made our decision for me. May we affirm this morning that decision in our life. To the glory of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please stand. We enter into the prayer of the church at this time. Gracious Father, through your Son Jesus, you invite us to come into your presence, not only singing hallelujah, but you are willing to let us speak from our heart and our mind about events and situations in our life that we always need help from you. And so we cry out, Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our congregation here at Grace, gracious Father. We ask that you'd continue to send forth the Holy Spirit among us and upon us, a gentle anointing, so that we will always have our focus on Jesus and continue by his grace to run the race that you have set before us, looking to Jesus, who is the pioneer and perfecter of our faith. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for Center Point congregation here in Camrose. We lift up before you Emmanuel Evangelical Lutheran Church in Rocky Mountain House and Pastor Brian. And we pray for our sister congregation in the city of Dnipropetrovsk, Living Waters. Lord, in your mercy, we remember families and people before you, Lord, that speak to our heart. We remember the Gunderson family. We remember our sister Letha and pray your blessing and anointing of Jesus upon her and each of her children and grandchildren. We lift up before you the students of CLBI as they return, as well as other students attending the University of Alberta here in Camrose. Lord, in your mercy, we ask, gracious Father, that you would continue to renew an evangelistic mind and heart in our midst. Continue to let this be shown through such ministries as the LWML, the Prayer Shawl Ministry, Lord. And Lord, we ask you also for each of the other, like Healing Prayer, which is on this coming Wednesday. Lord, continue to show us and direct us and lead and guide us so that we may be faithful in following you. Lord, in your mercy, amen. Please be seated. We're going to receive the offering first, so Ken, that will allow you a moment of just getting yourself together. So ushers, please come forward. And Ken, if you'd slowly make your way up to the lectern. Ushers. Ushers, please come forward. Please remain seated. We give thee but thine own, whatever the gift may be, all that we have is thine alone, a trust, O Lord, from thee. Amen. Ken here is, we know who he is. I mean, you folks will not know him, but he'll tell you who he is in just a moment. But I want to explain for us at Grace what's going on so that there isn't this, you know what's going on. During the adult Bible study, we had opportunity to take a look at what personal testimony is about and how effective that often is in our community. When we hear the story of another person. And Ken is not super Christian, so don't think that he's the best of the best. All in favor that he's not, raise your hand. Leanne, his wife, will clearly demonstrate that. But there are going to be two other people between now and the end of our church year. Louise Kurtz will be sharing a testimony on October the 2nd, and Landy Corbett will be sharing a testimony in September the 18th. What we're trying to do here at Grace as we're leading is to get to know each other by hearing the stories of one another. To develop this further, if you'll permit me, the youth on Sunday morning over in the parsonage, right over there, they are going to be hearing people from the parish tell their stories with the youth. So we learn to tell each other's story. And it just reminds us of a hymn of faith called, I Love to Tell the Story. It will be my theme in glory. The old, old story of Jesus and his love. How many of you like to tell stories about yourself? Raise your hand. Come on, God knows. We all like to tell stories about ourselves. Gee, you know, some are more prolific than others. One of those prolific storytellers is a guy named Ken Ma.
Okay. All right, I'm a third generation in camera, so I've been here a while. Okay. So, through the years as a kid, I went to the Messiah Lutheran Church because my parents made me go. And that's how I got introduced, but it was just mediocre. I wasn't really sure, but you kind of knew about him. So, over time, I live at an old place, my grandparents' place. Okay. And the mom's had eczema. My mind was behind my knees, and I had it ever since I was an infant. And I was always itching, to the point where I was itching and bleeding. So when we moved there, we moved away, and then we came back, grade five. I prayed constantly at that time for healing. And eventually it disappeared, probably roughly grade seven, grade eight. It was really, really disappeared. And I wasn't sure, but at that moment in time also, I felt things in the house, like uneasy in my room, kind of a ghostly feelings, you know, uneasy. Okay, so grew up, got out of there, went to Saint, prayed to God about important things in life, like meeting a girl, and of course I met my wife right afterwards. That was pretty cool. And then life just went on. I went and got work and this and that, and went to church now and then, and kind of really didn't really into it too much. And then over time, came over to this church. One of the reasons I came to this church is my brother was an elder, and he said it needed people, and I felt, well, I should go there, check it out, and maybe to help them out or the need, whatever. And then from that, the delivery and healing courses came in, and I said, really? There's such a thing? Okay, which is really cool. I figured, oh, I'll check it out. And got really involved in it. It was really good. So then the pastor invited some United States pastors here to teach on healing and deliverance. It was really cool. And then I remember that the little black guy, little black pastor came over and gave me a blessing, giving the Holy Spirit, the anointing of the Holy Spirit to me. Okay. And when I felt the Holy Spirit going into me, my comment was to myself, oh, thankfully familiar. Now, what actually happened back when I was a kid, and when I was praying for my knees to get healed, the skin, I felt the presence of evil in my room. And I asked the Lord at that time, give me the power to protect myself. And I did have it, but I thought it was like you just see on TV and this and that, the energies and stuff like that. So I figured it was just my imagination. But at that moment in time when the pastor anointed me with the Holy Spirit, it was the same energy. I did not know until that time the reality of God. So, I was anointed by the power of God back when I was a kid. I did not realize it, and I thought it was just my imagination, but it was real. And then, through the healing ministry and the courses we've taken, through the healings we've done, through going to the States for training, and then we've done the healing and deliverance ministry in this church, where we see healings constantly. The reality, the constant reality, the true power of God being in you to heal and to protect yourself against the evil ones is amazing. And even to the point that was really a funny story, you're going to ask me later about this for the ones that haven't heard the story about the ghost that kept on stealing this guy's underwear. Okay. It's real. The guy lives in Millet and sells those condo complexes, so those mobile homes. You got to ask that to me later on. It's funny, but it also gives the reality of the evil side and the power of God through the Holy Spirit to get rid of those things. Okay, so the true reality of God is really there through healing and deliverance, and I'm really grateful that your little one got baptized, because that is the power of God in you that protects you and guides you.
Thank you, Ken. Give thanks to the Lord. Oh, just wait here. Just wait. So for guests and visitors, as well as us this morning, when we receive Holy Communion today in the Narthex on the third Sunday of the month, Ken and Leanne and Eric, They are part of, you know, an emerging healing prayer team. There are others that are coming up. But if you'd like to go to them for healing, you're just asking the Lord to heal you. I invite you to go in the narthex. Often you'll come up for Holy Communion, and then just meander back there, and they'll be very happy to pray for you and over you, okay? Thanks, Ken. God bless. Will you please stand? We are using the confession of sin. Carolyn, we're going to sing the hymn, You Are the Way, the Truth, the Life, okay now? We're going to sing the hymn first. You are the way, through you alone. Truth, your word alone, true wisdom can impart. You are the life, the empty tomb, green arm. And those who put their trust in you, not death nor hell can harm. You are the way. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the aid of your people, turning us from our sin to live for Jesus alone. Give us the power of the Holy Spirit so that, attentive to your word, we may confess our sins, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Let us now confess our sins in the presence of God, our gracious Heavenly Father, and to one another. Gracious God, have mercy on us. In your compassion, forgive us our sins, known and unknown, things done and left undone. Uphold us by your Spirit, so that we may live and serve you in newness of life, to the honor and glory of your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy on you, forgive you all your sins, through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. Holy and mighty and merciful Lord, heaven and earth are full of your glory. In great love you sent to us Jesus, your Son, who reached out to heal the sick and the suffering, who preached good news to the poor, and who on the cross opened his arms to all people. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and he gave thanks. He broke this bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for remembrance of me." Again, after supper, Jesus took the cup and gave thanks, and then gave this cup for everyone to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Remembering, therefore, his death, resurrection, and ascension, we now await his coming in glory. Pour out your Holy Spirit, that by this Holy Communion we may know the unity that we share with all your people in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For through him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forevermore. Amen. We sing together, Lamb of God, Communion Assistant, and Healing Team, please come forward. John? John, please come forward. Eric, if you'll come over here. Take and eat. This is the true body of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, which is given for you. Amen. Take and drink. This is the blood of Christ, which is shed for you and shed for all people. Amen. Take and drink. This is the true blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, which is shed for you and shed for all people for the forgiveness of all your sin. Amen. And now may the true body and the true blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, keep you and strengthen you into life everlasting. Know this day that for Jesus' sake, God forgives you all your sin and sins. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Depart in his peace. Amen. Congregation, please be seated. Leanne. Remember, you have been marked the cross of Christ, and that for Jesus' sake you are God's son, that you are God's daughter, that you are God's son. Amen. Through these hands, O Lord, bring your Holy Spirit power and anointing so that all who come to you for prayer will be healed as you keep your word in their lives. Come, O Holy Spirit, for Jesus' sake. And through these hands, may the anointing of the Holy Spirit come and bring the healing power of Jesus to all who come to him for prayer. Amen. Remember that it is his authority, it's his power, it's his presence that you bring to those who come to Jesus for prayer. Go in his name and do his work. Amen. Take and eat the body of Christ. Take and drink the blood of Christ. And now may the true body and the true blood of our Lord and thank you. now may the true body and the true blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ keep you and strengthen you into life everlasting. Know this day that for Jesus' sake, God forgives you all your sin and sins. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Depart in his peace and follow Jesus. Amen. Congregation, please stand as we sing the last verse. Thanks to you, gracious Father, that you have renewed in us a living faith in Jesus, so that we will be turned from living for me and turned to living for Jesus. Amen. Please be seated. Please be seated. Announcements, announcements, announcements.
Good morning, all my brothers and sisters in Christ.
Good morning, Daryl.
Coming September 1st, Pastor Greg is teaching Lutherism 101. Learn what makes Luther's theology unique. Football night. Carpool to Edmonton to watch the Eskimos and the Riders battle for supremacy. Meet here at 5:30 p.m. to carpool to Edmonton for the game. Video Bible study Wednesdays at 10 o'clock to 11:45 a.m. Take part in the adventure of discipleship. Movie night. Tuesday, Ace Wonder Boy Detective. 7 o'clock p.m. Tuesday in the parish hall. Healing prayer service is rescheduled for this Wednesday, the 24th at 7 o'clock p.m. Bring your trouble to Jesus. He alone has the power to really heal. Thank you to all who participated in this year's VBS. Has anybody else got any announcements?
Thanks, Daryl. Yeah. I just want to take a moment and first of all say thank you to the family for coming for all the way from Edmonton and New Norway, if you're parked out there, and you're always welcome here at Grace Lutheran Church, and you never know when another baptism will be coming along the way. Amen to that. Amen. Just to highlight that in a couple weeks we will be resuming what we call fall time schedule. You know, first and foremost, our service starts at what time? 10 o'clock in the morning. And remember, soon after we start at 10, you'll have to change your clocks ahead. So don't get caught in this time change and so forth. Also coming up, as you can hear or see, and I hope that you're sensing, at Grace Lutheran Community, we have many activities which we sense will be effective in helping you walk with Jesus in your life. We have an active youth group coming up, you know, twice a month on Friday. Over in the parsonage, we'll be having youth ministry Sunday mornings. Over in the parsonage, we will be having youth ministry. I love to tell the story. I love to hear the story. So we adults, we're going to be the storytellers. So Dave Goss, if you'll all turn to see him back there, wave, Dave. He's going to be contacting you, coordinating a time when you're going to spend just 30 minutes talking with our youth, telling them about your life story, you know? It's really good to hear. Also coming up in November, we acknowledge that our families are in need of strength and help. We're starting the first of three what we call family missions. It's under the theme of renewing and restoring the Christian family. And we have a marriage family counselor coming from Sherwood Park. He's from Holy Trinity Roman Catholic Church, former Lutheran pastor. His name is Paul Quist and his wife Carol. They will be coming on a Friday night for 2 hours to talk about marriage and marriage family, and it's one of three, at least one of three. So I hope that there's opportunity for you. That's on November the 18th, so looking ahead. Ken, Leanne, Eric, and myself will be traveling to the Ukraine, middle of October, for a Ukraine mission again on healing and prayer ministry. So please check out here. You know, we are a parish that is running the race, a lot of activities. We hope that they're meaningful to each one, okay? Is there snacks downstairs? There is? Excellent. Let's stand and we sing Praise God, From Whom All Blessings Flow, as our dismissing hymn, as well as the benediction. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. Go in peace, serve our crucified and risen Lord.
Thanks be to God.